Oh, hi. I'm glad you're here. Have I got something to show you. Metro Toronto Convention Centre for the semi-annual vintage clothing show, and I am having a great time. Dresses, purses, jewelry, boots, and coats, sunglasses, formal wear, shoes, hats, and all things vintage. I'm with Catherine Knoll, organizer of the Toronto Vintage Clothing Show. Catherine, can you tell us a little bit about how the clothing show came together, history of it?
Sure. We've been running a vintage clothing show in Ottawa, and our vendors there all wanted to get something going in Toronto, being that it's a rather big market for vintage. A year and a half ago, we started the Toronto Vintage Clothing Show here. And so this is our third time out.
That is lovely.
It's from the 60s. It's all beaded. It's a shift dress design, so it just sort of fits nicely, not like too tight to your body. It's a very popular style in the 60s.
I think it looks gorgeous on you. It really complements your hair and complexion, and it's a perfect fit, so I think it's a winner.
Paul, can you tell us a little bit about the Costume Society of Ontario?
I certainly can. We have been around for 25 years or more now. It's an organization for people who are interested in costume as a reflection of society. We have people who are historians on military dress like me, or fashion of a particular period. People who work in the industry for film and television as costume designers and outfitters. People who are fashion designers or consultants. Museum people who work on research and so on like that. And people who are just interested in old clothes.
What do you think? Too decadent? I'm with Jackie of the Toronto Vintage Society. Jackie, what brings you to the Vintage Clothing Show today?
Well, hello, it's the Toronto Vintage Clothing Show. I'm meant to be here, pretty much born to be here. This is one of Toronto's biggest vintage clothing shows. So we're here not only to personally shop, but also to just take stock of some of the unique things that have been brought to Toronto today. A lot of vendors are from out of town, some as far as Sudbury, some are local, like Ego behind me right here, good friends of ours. So it's kind of nice to see it all come together and give a place for Toronto to shop all at once.
So I've heard that you're live posting here today. Tell me about how you have engaged some of the vendors.
Well, we feel it's a really good chance for us to show what some of the more unique pieces are in just a vintage collection. So everything from jewelry, going into winter coats right now, really unique pieces from different eras. So I feel like everybody should get a chance to showcase something that they have brought here to the Toronto Vintage Clothing Show. And so I'm taking pictures and posting live to Facebook. Although I know that this is not very vintage, the reality is it's the day and age we live in, and it's how we're connecting our vintage society here in Toronto.
And Jackie, I cannot let you go today until you tell me where you got your gorgeous outfit from.
I got this from one of my favorite shops, Gadabout Vintage Clothing, over on Queen Street East. Victoria's really good about picking out great dresses for me that fit my particular frame, usually a 50s fit and flare, lots of length. I need two crinolines to wear this thing, and of course my thermoset. I don't go anywhere without a little thermoset jewelry. Just completes the whole thing.
They are stunning, and I just want to get a picture of the earrings for the camera because they too are just stunning. Jackie, as always, looking lovely at every vintage event we go to, but in fact she lives it, so she's perfected it. I'm with Victoria.
Hi, Freda.
Hi. Can you tell me about Gadabout Vintage?
Absolutely. Gadabout started in 1997 with a store. We actually started earlier than that. We are one of the best curated stores in Toronto. We cover the end of the 1800s to the beginning of the 80s, end of the 1970s. We don't do jeans, we don't do t-shirts, and we just do fabulous stuff in great condition.
Whereabouts can we find you when you're not doing the vintage clothing show?
You can find us at 1300 Queen Street East, which is 1.5 blocks east of Leslie, open 7 days a week for your viewing pleasure. You can find us online at gadabout.ca or on Facebook at Gadabout Vintage.
I noticed that you have a new boy bag, but you're hanging around the vintage boy bags. What is it about the vintage pieces that attracted you?
They're vintage.
They're vintage pieces. I mean, Chanel is history. And
they're classic. They're just like an old muscle car, for example. They're always going to be better than the new Dodge Challenger or whatever. So old is gold, and vintage
classic
is the best.
Are the best.
I'm with Cindy of Chanel Touch. Cindy, can you tell me why Chanel?
Why not? Chanel is the ultimate dream classic bag for any lady. Breakfast at Tiffany's and Audrey Hepburn carried them in the 1950s, and we carry them today, the exact same bag, the same style that was popular and in demand 50 years ago is still today. That's the enduring classic nature of Chanel.
I'm with Jason of Jack Lux Vintage. Jason, I know that Jack Lux popped up a couple of months ago. Can you tell us about how that all came to be?
Sure. We have a shop in Montreal. All our inventory comes from Montreal. It was Costume Vintage, owned by the Quebec government. We took over their inventory a couple of years ago, and we've been selling it through Montreal. We decided, let's try out Toronto and see what it's all about.
Ian, I understand that if I want to know anything about vintage clothing, you are the man I should speak with. And you represent the Ian Drummond Collection. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
It's a vintage clothing collection that I have amassed over the last 25 years. I started in 1983. It rents to film and television primarily, and it's a labor of love that allows me to shop and keep. Of all the things that are the hardest to find in good condition, it's probably menswear. So I have built my whole collection around men's suits, and they come from like 38s, 40s, 42s, 44s, 48s, 54s, and then all of those decades from the 20th century. And that's because when someone is, or production is in town, or anywhere in the world filming, and they need clothing for background, you don't need one or two pieces, you need hundreds of them. And I'd have to say in most of my decades, I've probably got at least 200 or 300 of men's suits on the rack any given time for a production.
I really love it. I think I have to have it.
Excuse me, sorry, I actually just bought that.
I'm with Marla, and Marla, I know that you have been a part of the vintage scene for a long, long time. Can you just tell us anything you think we should know about it?
Well, I like to say I started back in the teens, which were my teens. So that is now coming up on many, many years. And I like to come to shows like this, not just to work, because it's very exciting seeing vintage clothing go out into the world and be worn and enjoyed, which is how it was meant to be. But I like seeing how it changes over the years. We're now as far away from the 80s as we were from the 50s. So for me to start seeing 90s ditzy prints and grunge wear as vintage is almost hurting my soul.
In your opinion then, how has it changed most dramatically in recent years?
Recently, and recently being the advent of the internets, mainly being Etsy, that we now have a generation of vintage clothing finders, people who go out and search for it and are able to sell it without the expense of a retail overhead store. Changed how people shop, it changed how people find things. When they sit down to go looking for something, they can type in what they want and it can be there. So that changed retail. It was the tiger that ate its tail.
So next weekend at the Exhibition Place at Queen Elizabeth Hall, we're going to have a big show which combines antiques, vintage clothing, vintage items like vintage houseware, and retro. So it's going to be a wide range with about 60 to 70 vendors.
This week we're at part two of the Vintage Doubleheader. We're at the Toronto Vintage and Antique Market. Caught up with some ladies from the Toronto Vintage Society, Liz, Stephanie, and Shermie. Ladies, any luck today?
I've gotten lucky so far, and I've only been in the first two rows. I purchased this fantastic 1940s Eaton's catalog, and with my blog, The Vintage Inn, I absolutely love Canadian vintage stuff, so this is perfect. Can't wait to shop. Wish I could buy some, but...
I haven't quite found anything. I'm on the hunt for vintage glasses today. But there's lots of great stuff here, so yeah. I'm hoping I can still find something.
I bought a little cute cotton dress for a short person. So that's good.
I'm with Mike and Lois, and I came across some very interesting pieces here. This in particular, can you tell us a little bit about it, Mike?
It's made in Hamilton, and it's roughly 1930s, and it's a hair curler for a salon. They'd sit at a chair and curl it in your hair. I'd probably do two people, I think. That'd be maybe two at once.
Mike and Georgie, and I know these folks have been in here for a while, and now I know why. He could not let it go. Mike, what are you going to do with your buys today?
Well, this sign, I couldn't pass it up because in my basement I actually created a diner, and it just fits the bill exactly for what I was looking for. And this here, I have a theater that I created in my basement, and I've been looking for some vintage theater stuff, so this fits the bill too.
Nothing about this that isn't perfect. Detail. And look, it's slit down the back, and then it's got tiny buttons at the waist.
No short
started to vintage shopping these last couple of weekends at the Toronto Vintage Clothing Show and Toronto Vintage and Antique Market. So, until I see you again in 6 months for the next semi-annual, take care.